show you how to connect our code changes and push these code changes to GitHub. GitHub is a version control cloud platform. So every single change that you make, every time you push it in, push a change for a file, it keeps track of all the different changes. So you have an option to roll back. It is also like how we used to like take backup of our code and then it's maintained on the cloud for you to access anytime. So before we even do, you click on this fork here to go to version control. You probably will see us say like, you'll see here say create a new repository or use an existing. Click on create a new repository. I already did that, so it's not showing that to me. Okay, you have to click on connect to GitHub. Before you do this step, you should already have an account in GitHub. Okay, so I have an account in GitHub. So that should be done before. So I have to click on connect to your GitHub. So what happens is like a GitHub will grant access. So we are granting access for repl to access GitHub. That's what we are doing. So click on this button. And then it won't ask you this because if you only have one repository, it won't ask you. If you have multiple repositories, choose which one you want to give it, which user ID. Click install and authorize. So that is done. Second step is to click on this connect to GitHub. So here, because I chose create a new repository, it is telling me, okay, your project name is test1. I'm going to create a repository called test1 in GitHub. See, this is my user ID in GitHub that I gave access to, and then test1. Okay, you can keep it as public or private, up to you. So we'll make it as private and then create the repository. So it says up to date with master. That's what we want to see. Now let's go to GitHub and refresh the page. Go to repositories. Test1 made it all the way here. If you open test1, you can see the two files, main.cs and main.exe. Click on main.cs. The same code changes I have in my repl, those two lines made it here. Okay, so that is the goal of this exercise. Let us say like you today you made these changes, it's a big project, so you're adding changes over a period of time. Okay, and then you want to remove this line. Okay, so once you make this, you run your changes and then everything works here exactly how you want it. You go to your version control and say what you changed. You just give a comment saying updated line 6, whatever you want, and then click on commit and push. Now if you go here and refresh this page, so the line changed, line 2 changed. So you can see a history. If you click on history, you can see a history of all the changes made to this particular application. So first we created the application, then we updated the line. So all of that made it here. So that's the whole idea. So this is how you connect GitHub and repl. One other thing you have to think about is anytime you create a new repository, for me to be able to see it, so this is the repository, right? Test1. Once you make your changes for your lab, you go to settings. Because it's a private repository, I cannot see it, so you have to go here to manage access. Invite a collaborator and put my name here. Oh, I can't see because it's me. So, but you should be able to see a username. I always like trip on this one. So that's my user ID. You have to like type the full user ID and I will provide that in your labs. And then you have to say, here it'll get you invite a collaborator. Unless you do the step, I will not be able to see your changes in GitHub. Okay. So let's go back to test1. Okay. So that's how you do it. Another thing I want to show you is you can also share this link with me. You can use my user ID here, or you can copy this link. So let's see, and then share that on to show your changes. So that link will take me directly to your page. Hope this helps. So let's go one more time. So this is my folder. If you want to see all of your, like after like 3 weeks, you'll have like three different folders, right? So if you click here on your user ID, let's go here, home. That's your main page. Click on my repls, and you will have all your projects here. So lab one, lab two, lab three, you'll have 8 labs here, okay? So, and then all you have to do is like click on the lab, and then you can see your lab and run your code anytime. So please remember, this repl.it is going to be the website. We are using an online version of a compiler for C#. So it's called the Mono C# compiler. Instead of using Visual Studio, we are using this because it's much easier for anyone. You know, with a Chromebook, you can do it. You know, with a Mac, you can do it.